Attack Simulation Training is an intelligent phish risk reduction tool that empowers employees to prevent attacks, measure users' awareness of phishing risk, provide actionable insights and recommendations to use hyper-targeted training that can change users' behavior, and then measure behavioral change through repeated simulations. All of this right in the Microsoft 365 Defender portal. On the Attack Simulation Training page, you see the most recent simulations you've run. Plus, you know how many users in your org have experienced simulations and the percentage of users who have completed related trainings. On the right, you see how users' behaviors have impacted the compromise rate over time. And my favorite is the chart at the bottom of the page that describes the number of repeat offenders broken out by the type of attack. Of course, you can drill into this data with relevant filters to identify those people who need a bit more training to avoid these attacks. Next to that is a short list of simulations that we recommend you run and why. To get started, you can launch an individual simulation by selecting Launch a Simulation. Then, choose the social engineering technique you want to use. In this case, I'll go with the default, the credential harvest technique. Give the simulation a descriptive name, select Next, and then select the payload you want to use. In this case, I'll use the built-in two failed messages payload. Later, I'll show you how to create your own payloads. On the target users page, you can choose specific users and groups you want to target with this simulation, or you can simply target everyone with it. That's what I'll do here. Then, on the assigned training page, configure how you want to handle training for users who demonstrate the need. Our huge library of phish training content enables personalized and highly specific targeting based on susceptibility score or simulation performance. In this case, I'll just use the recommended defaults, which is to use Microsoft content and assignments, but you can also use a custom landing page and assign specific trainings. All the trainings are brief, with most clocking in at under 7 minutes, but they can be an effective way to change users' behaviors. If you're using the Microsoft training experience, you can customize its header and body text. Don't forget to preview the page by selecting Preview Page. Not only does this page link users to assigned training, but it also gives them a tour of the email to explain the telltale signs they missed. Great stuff. Next, on the Launch Details page, specify when to start and how long to run the simulation. And then, review the details and submit the simulation to Microsoft 365 Defender. Once done, you see the simulation on the Simulations tab, along with all the others you've run or are running. At the top of this tab, you see the status of all these simulations, and you can select your new simulation to see its details. There's a lot of information here, like the impact of the simulation or how many users it actually compromised. We provide an extensive list of payloads based on real-world attacks right out of the box, like the two failed messages payload I used earlier. There are more than enough to get started, but you can also create custom payloads. While you can certainly start from nothing, I prefer to use an existing payload as a starting point by selecting Copy Payload. Then, click through the wizard to customize each page. On the Configure Payload page is where you customize every detail of the payload. That includes sender information, the phishing link, tags and general information, language, and of course, the email body itself. You can edit this email any way you like. Moving on, remember earlier I mentioned that the landing page can show users signs that they might have missed? Those are indicators, and you can add them here on the Add Indicators page. Select Edit Indicator to edit an existing one, and click in the Indicator Preview area to see what it will look like to users. Once you're done, submit your payload to create it. There's just a few more things I want to show you in Attack Simulation Training. The first is simulation automations, which can run simulations containing up to 10 payloads that you choose, or let us randomize, over a period of time. You select a start and end date, the days of the week to start simulations, maximum number of simulations to run, and whether to randomize the send times. Other than choosing the payloads and scheduling the automation, creating an automation is like creating a single simulation, so we don't need to walk through the process here. The second thing I wanted to show you is payload automations. Rather than trying to create payloads from scratch or using the built-in payloads, you can harvest payloads straight out of your mail flow. In this case, I want to harvest payloads that phish credentials. You find those harvested payloads on the Payloads tab. The name begins with the name of the automation, making it easy to find them by simply searching for the name of the automation. We encourage you to try Attack Simulation Training in the Microsoft 365 Defender portal to measure and improve users' behavior. To learn more about it, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.